Isang grupo ng Palawenyo ang nagsusulong upang mabigyan ng karagdagang proteksyon ang ating kalikasan at likas na yaman. Sila ang Center for Sustainability PH at ang grupong ito pinamumunuan ng isang babae. Let's meet Karina May Reyes Antonio, a conservation lobbyist, community organizer, and National Geographic Explorer, and a proud Filipina, dito lang sa Expert Talk Online.
Ang Palawan ang itinuturing na last ecological frontier sa Pilipinas dahil sa likas na yaman at mga endemic species ng hayop at halaman na dito lamang matatagpuan. Ngunit hindi mawawala ang banta ng pagkasira nito dahil sa mga aktibidad gaya ng iligal na pagputol ng puno, panguhuli ng mga endangered na hayop at mabilis na urbanisasyon. Kaya naman, to the rescue, ang Center for Sustainability PH, isang environmental group sa Palawan na pinamumunuan ni Karina upang maprotektahan ang natitirang forest covers sa bansa. At dahil sa kanila, na italaga bilang pinakamalaking critical habitat sa Pilipinas ang Cleopatra's Needle.
Magandang araw, Miss Karina!
Hello po! Magandang araw po. Galing Palawan.
First of all, congratulations sa Center for Sustainability PH. Turned 5 years old this month. Tama ba? And your organization is really doing an amazing job. But paano ba nagsimula itong pagbuo ninyo ng Center for Sustainability PH? Can you please tell us more about this group?
As often happens po with mga passion projects, it starts with a dream that you'd like to make come true. So we first started in this area called Cleopatra's Needle, which is the highest mountain of Puerto Princesa City. It's 1,593 meters above sea level, and it's the third highest peak in Palawan. So for mountaineers, it's very famous as being part of our trilogy, the mountaineering trilogy. So the area is actually now 41,350 hectares. So it covers 11 communities, 7 barangays, so 3 upland indigenous communities and 7 lowlander coastal communities. The area is equivalent to 2/3 of our national capital region. It's also the ancestral domain of the indigenous Batak community. Only 200 members are remaining. And so there's 6 of us in our team, and we had this dream to protect this area. Yung mga kasama ko po, they're taga talaga yung mga barangay in and around Cleopatra's Needle. And so for 2 years po, we were working in different efforts in order to protect the area bilang critical habitat, to become a protected area po. And then finally, after 2 years, we realized that it can't just be a passion project, because what we're trying to do is really change policy with this environmental designation. So we formally incorporated in 2016, and we've continued doing the work, but in a more formal way and with a stronger voice for our organization.
Ayon sa batas, ang lahat ng naitalaga bilang critical habitat ay kailangang maprotektahan, katuwang ang lokal na pamahalaan mula sa mga aktibidad na maaaring maging dahilan ng pagkasira nito at makaapekto sa kaligtasan ng mga threatened species na naninirahan dito.
Ano yung mga initiatives, ano yung mga activities na nagawa ninyo para mas mapangalagaan pa itong lugar na to?
In consultation with our indigenous communities, because one of the biggest parts about the Center for Sustainability PH that we always say is that our work comes from communities, is for communities, and goes to communities. So they really shape all of our projects. So the very first project that we started was this project to protect the area. So this is the Cleopatra's Needle Critical Habitat ngayon. And with that, it started because yung mga katatubo, they really wanted to have some kind of piece of paper to show that the area really belongs to them, that they have primordial rights over the area. And the other process through indigenous designation is very complicated and takes many more years. And one of the issues that we're seeing is that we are losing our forest cover very, very quickly. And so what we decided as an environmental group is that we could meet halfway. And so what we would do is we would work for this environmental designation together with the indigenous communities. We would get this formal protection. And then later on, these are the basic steps for them to later on get indigenous designation also over the area. After that, we do scientific research, which is the really exciting part of our work. We get to collaborate with many different organizations and academic institutions so that they can come in and make all these wonderful discoveries of the area. And then finally, once we have the consent of our communities and the proof of science, we lobby to our local politicians and decision makers. So that's our major, major project. We have two other flagship projects that I'll talk about very briefly. The second one is our Saving the Almasiga Tree project. And with that one, we are doing a reforestation of the sacred tree that is a key livelihood species of the indigenous Batak. And we were able to reforest our area with 15,063 seedlings. And then finally, our last project is the Knowledge is Power of the Forest project, which almost brings everything full circle. And so what we do now is we train our local indigenous enforcers to be able to do the biodiversity research independently. So we're no longer as dependent on outside scientists to help us understand and really document our area.
Isa sa kahanga-hangang gawain ni Nakarina ay ang pagtuturo sa mga lokal na mamamayan ng ilang mga siyentipikong kaalaman at kakayahan upang maging citizen scientists.
Ano-ano ba yung mga skills na na-share nyo na doon sa community? Paano sila tinetrained? And paano talaga nagkaroon ng kaibahan yung nakagawian na nila?
As I said earlier, they really shape all of the activities that we do and what kind of projects you want to implement there. So with their guidance, we really looked at areas where we could help them, assist them in what they want to do. So we did ecotourism livelihood trainings with them, had yung biodiversity monitoring survey trainings with them so they can learn to do these biodiversity surveys independently while they're on patrol. We did lots of different resource management activities with them also, so that when it came time for the area to be protected, they had the tools in order to be able to protect the area. And also very exciting, yung Almasiga project po talaga, the reforestation project. In fact, it had never been done before sa buong Pilipinas, this strategy of collecting the seeds and nurturing them in these nurseries and then finally reforesting them back into the forest. So all of these activities had trainings every part so that they really could independently take charge later on.
So Miss Karina, paano na-accept nung community yung mga sinishare ninyong knowledge or yung mga initiatives na ginagawa ninyo?
Syempre, in every community, you have different dynamics. Some people that are with what you're doing and some people that are not so with what you're doing. Pero again, passion, patience, perseverance, and above all, be makulit. And they generally come around. And ayun po, we've really seen so many concrete changes with our communities, their attitude, their pride in the area, and just their conviction that they do have the right to protect this area because it is so important to them po.
Okay, so since you're celebrating this year, 5 years na kayo ang Center for Sustainability PH, any future plans naman ng inyong organization?
The other major project that we actually have now is in southern Palawan. It's an area called Kunsad. It's also a really beautiful peak of our mountain ranges in the south of Palawan. And it's 8,000 hectares, and we're trying to protect this one also. So it's very similar to what we did at Cleopatra's Needle. But again, we haven't been able to do the community organizing and scientific research. But we're working on it now. We're slowly opening up here in Palawan. So please cross your fingers for us that we can get in soon. Because this is normally expedition season for us. This is our busiest time of the year normally. And we can't get into the area to do the research. So ayan po.
Parehong Pilipino ang mga magulang ni Karina. Ngunit sa Sydney, Australia siya ipinanganak at lumaki. Mula pa man noon, malapit na sa puso ni Karina ang pakikipagtulungan sa iba't ibang komunidad.
Actually po, yung background ko po talaga ay community organizing. So I first started doing real community work in Latin America. Medyo iba. And at the time, I was working more with youth groups. I was working in educational rights, in women's rights, housing rights. I wasn't really sure at the beginning of my career what I really wanted to do exactly. I just knew that the most important part of my work was working with our communities. And then it was while I was doing this work and I was studying at the same time that I did this really incredible course on environmental security. And so from there, I realized na parang if I really want to make an impact and a difference, I need to work with these communities in ways that makes them less vulnerable to environmental disasters. Many of the slums and very poor communities that I was working in was really vulnerable to landslides, to flash flooding, to poor sanitation from plastic waste and other issues na ganyan. And after that, I realized, okay, I want to keep working with communities, but I really want to look at it in an environmental, through an environmental lens. But, and also, my background is political sciences. So okay. For me, policy should be the backbone of all of our work. If you want to make an impact, you need to change policy. That is really is what's going to make our work sustainable and long-lasting. After all of our passion and our efforts, and we're no longer on this beautiful earth, the policies sana will still be there to ensure that for our future generations, there is real impact.
Taong 2014, nang unang makarating si Karina sa Palawan, at dahil nabighani siya sa ganda nito, dito na siya nanirahan at ipinagpatuloy ang kanyang adhikain na pangalagaan ang inang kalikasan.
What are the challenges that you have faced in this field that you chose?
So it's really interesting po, kasi it's National Women's Month ngayon, di ba po? So I was actually talking with one of my colleagues at CSC, Aubrey Padilla, and I said to her, "Obs, do you... like, is there any advantage sa tingin mo, like, to be a woman?" And we were like, actually, there's not. Like, it's very unfortunate in our field of work. But from the field all the way to boardrooms when we're doing lobbying, it's very male-dominated. So I would never say that it's an advantage. It's actually very much a challenge in our work. Pero at the end of the day, if you're passionate, you're persistent, and you persevere, and you show your stakeholders that you're not going to go away, na makulit ka talaga, parang we've seen real changes with especially male leaders that maybe don't want to work with us or doubt our strengths, whether that's to hike all the way to the top of Cleopatra's Needle, which takes 4 days, or if it takes, or if it's, you know, writing a report or lobbying policy to our local decision makers, parang nakita nila na we're very tiyaga and we're not going to go away. So, ayan po.
Pangarap ni Karina na mas dumami pa ang mga Pilipinong hindi takot at handang ipagbigay alam sa mga kinauukulan ang mga problemang kinakaharap ng bayan upang ito ay masolusyonan.
I want there to be justice for all minority groups. You know, this is the kind of work that we're doing. Environmental justice is a really big part of social justice. And for that to happen, what I hope for our country specifically and the rest of the world, but very importantly for our country, is that we have an electorate that is engaged, that is talking with our local decision makers, that is not scared to speak out, that wants to, shows their voice and shows their opinions to their local decision makers. When we as a mass, a critical mass, are speaking to our decision makers in a diplomatic way about what matters to us, things will definitely change. When we vote, things will change. So, ayun po, I'm hoping that we become a stronger democracy and therefore there's more space for dialogue between minority groups and decision makers to really change policy in a way that is sustainable and long-lasting for, especially for our minorities.
Okay. So, Ms. Karina, what is your message to young Filipina?
My message to young Filipinas is there is no greater time than the present to be a part of changing our beautiful country. I think there's no more important time for every single discipline, whether you're an artist, an engineer, a conservationist, a lobbyist, a presenter, to be a part of this change. And so it doesn't matter what your discipline is, it's going to take literally everybody to get on board to face these great challenges that our planet faces. And so ayun po, be a part of the change.
Isa lamang ang grupo ni na Karina sa mga naglulunsad ng mga inisyatibo para mapangalagaan ang ating likas na yaman. Hindi nga maaaring maging batayan ang kasarian ng isang tao kung ano ang kaya niyang gawin. Dahil sa huli, ang angking kakayanan at dedikasyon sa kahit anumang larangan ang kailangang pahalagahan. Ako po si Jel Miranda at ito ang Expert Talk Online.